Hey everybody, welcome back to Jenny from the Chopping Block. And tonight I have an amazing, not only friend, but an amazing person that I want to share with you guys, Zal.
Woo!
Woo!
And Zal and I actually met at a Tony Robbins event. I was trying to think of what event we actually met. Was it LA?
Yes.
Okay, so we met in LA, and it was kind of funny how we met because Zal and I both signed up to do the to support the fire team. What is it called? Is that what it is?
Yeah,
fire team. And what position did we both sign up for?
It was, I think, was it the celebration?
Celebrators, right?
Yeah.
So this is my first time doing it. I actually, you know, have done it a few times after, and it's such an amazing experience. But me and Zal actually shared the celebrator position. I'm not really sure how it worked out because it's usually,
I was part of my position, and then I was also part of the vision. I mean, the ninja team. And then because we were so busy, they replaced me. And then I came back, and they're like, "Well, just have two." And I'm like, "Yeah, let's go."
And it worked out really cool. I thought we made a really good
really
team
well.
Because absolutely. I would kind of like embrace the people after they walked on fucking fire, excuse my language. And then Zal would like just hype them up and like send them off. So I felt like we had a really good dynamic.
It was a really good assembly.
Yeah. Really, I was like, hug, you're good. Congrats, you did it. And then you were like,
I felt I was gonna have a stroke that night. It was just so much.
It was, you know, I kind of
like, insane.
Yeah, I was like reverse sweating, if that makes any sense. Like I love doing silent angel now because I kind of just make sure everyone's safe and send them on their way, and I get to see when they make that decision, you know, that they're gonna do it. I feel like we see them on the other end when we're celebrating their victory. It was just really cool. So anyway,
the main point is people should crew.
So it's amazing. I'm almost like, I know I have to get back to an event to like attend, but I'm like addicted to crewing. So we'll see how that works out. So then after that, there was some stuff that went down, and me and Zal wound up being in the same mastermind, which I found really interesting. Like, we were just meant to be friends, and you've just been so supportive to me throughout these past 2 years, where Zal actually like came to different hospitals and nursing homes and just super supportive. I love you to death. And oh, most importantly, so I started doing wellness events in my community. Mm-hmm. And Zal was the first host that I had.
Oh, I did not know that, actually.
Yeah, you were my first host for my wellness event. So I had people coming into a storefront, and then I would try to share with them some of the stuff that I've learned. And Zal hosted one of my events, and he taught people how to create and explore their visions. And the feedback that I got from my audience was exceptional. So I think I'm selfishly asking you to come back because I need a refresher. But I also want to share your insights and experiences with everyone else. So can you tell us how, I guess, just dive into what, you know, what we talked about earlier?
Absolutely. So I became obsessed with vision boards, and it's insane how I did that. I had a coach, his name was Thomas Wang. He showed me what vision boards were, and I didn't know. And it was incredible. Hence, my vision board is right behind me. But then when I went to crew, somebody else, her name is Trixie, who inspired me to see vision boards. And from there, I just became so obsessed with vision boards. I'm like, this is it. This is the answer to everything. Because people are trying to achieve so much, but they don't have their thoughts straight. And vision boards have been taught for years and years, right? They've been taught all over by the best people in the business. Mm-hmm. Everything starts with a picture, right? Mm-hmm. We are visual beings.
I'm a visual learner. Yeah, right? Definitely.
Absolutely. And so I just became obsessed with this whole vision board. It has, I mean, there's different types of vision boards. but I really think I found something from that I learned from my mentors and just studying different things that really, really works for myself and a lot of people. And you've experienced it, which was really awesome. This is me trying to test it with different people and test different ideas. And it's just been, I learned so much about it every freaking time.
So I just want to show you like two vision boards that I have. One of them is, so I do two different styles. So I have like, it's kind of like what's it called? That Pinterest, like you get all the pictures and oh so you get all the pictures and you have different words. But then recently, this is the one I want help with because that one's a little personal. Hold on one sec.
You went big on that one because
Huh?
you have a Home Depot box. You went big on
This
that
is my moving box. I was like, I'm not gonna let this go to waste. So I just made this one. Me and my brother and my sister did a vision board party the last full moon. And I kind of did the magazine route. So that's when you like take a bunch of random magazines and you cut out random words and pictures that resonate. So I'm curious to what your style is and what you recommend. I'm sure you could do both, but
You
I
can
just.
totally both, right? You can do totally both. It depends. It always depends on your intention. And there's a lot of vision boards, and some people see it as something fun. And I'm going to go a little bit against that idea. All right. It shouldn't just be fun. Yes, fun is part of the formula. But honestly, when people get to the science and the art of what they're really attracting, it's your vision. Your vision is what attracts everything, whether it's good stuff or bad stuff, right? So my style that I learned and I liked is to actually go with pictures and words to kind of expand a little bit deeper into the words, right? We have so much in our mind. We are so overwhelmed too. We are really overwhelmed with so many things that we want to do, especially being part of this self-development world. Oh my God,
Bunch
right?
of overachievers.
Exactly. They want to do everything. And it's overwhelming and it's here. You can't see everything. So, what I like doing with my vision board is to extract all of that, right? Extract all of that into paper. So, one of the first questions is, what areas in your life are you trying to grow? What is your top six or your top three or your top nine? Like for me, I have nine categories. And some examples are finances, family, religion, contribution. Like those are my highlights that I want to contribute to my life. And so from there, once you identify those big categories, boom. Are you freaking kidding me? Like the relief just to have that on paper in front of you is so huge. So once you have your particular categories under that, you put particular categories that are quantifiable. Like that's how your brain works. It wants to see some sort of result. It doesn't want to see vagueness sometimes, right? It wants some sort of result. It's
Very
almost like,
detailed, yeah.
yeah, it's almost like when I say, hey, Jenny, can you go get us something from Walmart? And then you go to Walmart and you're like, what? I'm like, what should I get? He didn't even tell me. You're lost. You're
Or
like,
you
do I
go
get
there for one
Spanish
thing and you come
or
back with
Jamaican?
everything but that.
Oh,
I do
exactly, right?
that a lot.
But when I say, hey, Jenny, here's a list of things you need to go get me from Walmart, you know exactly where to go, you know which aisle probably. Like you'll save less, it'll be less time for you and you'll come back quicker. You got everything I asked you. This is the same thing with that type of vision board. Under each category, for example, let's say we'll take maybe contributions. I have there 50 plus volunteer events, right? I have 10K in charity. As you notice, like everything is quantified and I have a defined subcategory. So that way, when you look at your vision board, there is no freaking way that you'll ever be bored. You will not run out of things to do because you're like, oh my God, I have 50 volunteer events I have to do. I can just choose one and go. Like, what should I do with my day? Oh, I can freaking, start developing a little personal program. Oh, I can I can give $10 to charity. Oh, I can make a video on Facebook. Like, it gives you stuff to do because sometimes people don't know what to do. I'm like, I don't know where to start. Look at your damn vision board. You'll know where to start. You know what I mean?
Literally.
And
It
so,
just,
like,
it's
yeah,
so
from there.
helpful. No, I know, I remember I have my business one over, I have like a couple of, but I have my business one and just like, it's so much more fun, like to actually, you have your vision of what you want and then you look at it. But when you have those details, like it's game changer.
It give I think everybody's after clarity.
Yeah.
Everybody's overwhelmed and they're after clarity, right? They're like, yes, I want to help people, but I don't know like what to do. You know, I want to help people, but I don't know what to do. And so when you empty your mind into paper, this is what all these self-development gurus are trying to do. They're trying to give you clarity so you can see your why and see your path. And this is a huge part of it, right? And so once we have those subcategories, this is when the magazines or the pictures comes in. What I try to tell people is when you're choosing these pictures from a magazine or online or whatever, make sure you that resonates with you. Those pictures resonates with you. The words resonate with you. The colors resonate with you. The categories resonate with you. Because once you look at your vision board, you feel good. And when you feel good, you have less resistance to what? To get all of that, to attract and manifest, or to send a vibration to wherever. I'm like, here's the picture, here's the categories. God, please let it happen. You know what I'm saying? I feel like it's right
Amazing. Wow, that's amazing. So, can you share a little bit more about like how like so it, what would the process look like when I did my event? I had magazines laid out,
Right.
and then I see you have your pictures and then you have your
Yes.
categories right next to it.
Yep.
I need to do that.
So yeah, so I mean, I wanted to line it up really well, right? Because each picture right next to each category means it really connects with that, right? Like I'll give you like a perfect example. So I have this one is relationships, right? Right there, relationships. And then next to it is actually the word relationship, but it looks like a construction site. Right, so that picture means so much to me.
Oh,
Each relationship takes a lot to fix, to put together, to fix, to enhance, whatever. So each picture really touches my heart, and it equally, relates to what I have written. So for people, they need to think about their categories, their subcategories, their pictures, right? And once they have that vision board and it's ready like this, you better not put it in your damn closet. That's what I'm gonna say. A lot of people are guilty, a lot of people are guilty of that. And I really think the reason why a lot of us are guilty of that is because they just did it for fun. They didn't do it as, oh my God, this is something that's gonna actually impact my life.
Yeah.
Like, this thing needs to be in your room.
I really believe in
Okay.
these folks 'cause like I mean I have what I want most next to my freaking pillow. Like when I wake up before I go to bed, I look at it. I would like to do the detailed writing and the outline, but I look at that a lot. And then I
Yeah.
have my other ones, all over the place, but
It's like you got both of them, and then you look. Are you talking to me? Are you talking?
I'll check you later. No.
It's like, you know what? When you read a lot about manifestation and meditation, they tell you, hey, when you're trying to manifest, either do it before you go to sleep or when you wake up, because when you wake up, your brain is still receptive, right? There's no resistance. So when you have this in your room, you know what I'm saying? You wake up, you look at it, you're like, hey, what's up, cutie? You know what I'm saying? Like, there's that relationship right there,
That's
And
amazing.
it like it's a listen, our mind is so infinite, right? Because you never know when you wake up one day and you see a picture or whatever, and then it can trigger something in your mind. Like it can remind you know
Yeah.
what I'm saying?
To
Like,
take action. Yeah.
that's just the way we are. We have millions and millions of thoughts right there. This is going to remind you. This is a reminder of your why. This is a reminder of why you're working hard. This is a reminder of what you got left. This is a reminder of your big vision. Like, it's right there, right in front of you. It's a room. It's a, I mean, this is how you force a habit, right? Forcing a habit is you do it over and over and over. Eventually, it sticks. This is the same thing with visualization. You look at it over and over and over to the point where, you know, the vibration or whatever said, "All right, I got it. I got you. Stop." You know what I'm saying? Here, take it. Take what you're looking for.
Well, I do want to talk more about that because, you know, the first vision board I've ever seen was my aunt's, and she had it up in her house for years. Like, I just remember it. Like, I remember seeing it. And, you know, I feel like she just recently bought like her big dream house, you know, on the water, like really, really nice. And I mean, it worked because
That's
that was
good.
her vision, and that was on her vision board. And I remember looking at it as a kid, like, that's cool. Like, that's what you want. Like, you know, and now it didn't. And my question to you is, so it sometimes it takes time,
Yes,
because
it
that was
does.
like 15 years or 20 years. Like, but she finally got that big goal, you know.
You've got to be, this is, that's the thing. You've got to be patient, right? It's just like anything else. It's going to take a lot of work, right? It's going to take a lot of work. Here's what this vision board does, right? And I really want to get this myth out of people's mind. You can't put a vision out there and expect things to just, you know, start achieving things for you. It's going to take some work, right? What this vision board does, and really take note of that, what this vision board does, it's like a compass, right? It's like a compass. It's like you're walking in the desert. Well, let's put two scenarios, right? You could be walking in the desert and you're just walking randomly, right? And you know, along the way, eventually you might get lost. Who knows? What a vision board is, it's a compass in a desert. It shows you which way to go. It reminds you where you have to be. So because you are taking all these visions and pictures into your mind, your brain starts showing you things. It's just like that. I think Tony Robbins talked about this. I forgot what exactly it's called, but if you buy a particular brand of a car or a purse or a
Oh
phone,
yeah.
and then all of a sudden you start seeing it everywhere. People didn't wait for you until you bought this to buy this item.
Where
People do
focus
that.
goes, energy flows.
Exactly. Your brain says, "Hey, you're interested in this. Hey, you're interested in this because you wrote it in your vision board." So basically, your vision board reminds you, but it's up to you to take that action. You know what I mean? It really gives you what you want, but it's up to you to say, "Yep, I'm gonna go for that. Yep, I'm gonna take action on that." But it's what an amazing resource for it to just happen for you.
I love them. And you know what? I love the creative side of it. I love getting my feelings, like what's put in my heart, like out into a visual representation of that. And it's not gonna hurt. So even if
That's
it, you know, I believe in it and I love it. And I appreciate you kind of taking it a step further with us because, you know, I just always thought that it was just like, all right, you put up the pictures, but to be able to go in and kind of work out those thoughts of the detail.
yeah, it's so important. It's so important because it is, it's your guide and it meets you halfway. That's what it is. It meets you halfway. And that's when things start to happen. I mean, obviously there's a lot more stuff that needs to happen along in that journey, but it gives you such a huge foundation.
Well, thank you for sharing that. And I want to ask you also, what else can you talk to the audience about regarding like morning routine? Because I know we've been in the same kind of
Yes.
pretty much the same space for the past year and a half. So
Well, lucky for you, right? I had an amazing and huge realization today. Seriously, I was so psyched. I'm like, I can't wait to get on live. And I didn't tell you ahead of time because I'm like, I'm just gonna share it when we're there. So just to back up a little bit, right? After you create your vision board, you should create a routine, right? It's just like exercise. Only way you lose weight is if you exercise every day. Similar to this, if you want this to kind of speed up and take charge and run, you need to create a routine with that. And so that comes with visualization, daily visualization. What I really try, like we're learning a lot of different things. So feel free to use all that things to create it into your visualization, whether it's Tony stuff, Master Co. I love using Master Co style. I love that. If you guys remember in that Twin Hearts meditation, he does this. and you close your eyes and you're throwing gold light into your family, to the world, blah, blah.
He did
And
one
it's
this morning and
amazing.
he's doing one tonight.
Oh, tune in.
I'll post it. Yeah.
So that to me, if people can do that on a daily basis, but instead of, family or whatnot, you take something that's resonating with you that day from your vision board, and you just freaking boom, you just power that up with so much gold light and energy, just so you can beam it right up to wherever it needs to go. That touches my heart because Master Ko proved that it works, right? He did it in the audience where people can feel something. Everybody confirmed it, and you felt good and you felt relaxed. Now imagine where that thing is feeling. I don't know. Was it? I don't know. No, you are not my partner, but when I was doing that, there was somebody above me to see if they can feel something, and she said the more deeper Master Ko went, the more pressure she can feel. Like, what the hell is that? You know what I'm saying? Like, it blows my mind. It's like the mystery. I don't know what it is, but it works. So why not on your vision? So create a daily routine with visioning every day. Whether it's that or your own, there's so many different ways of visualization. Like, it would take hours and hours to talk about a lot of them. So whatever you feel connects with you, do that as a routine daily. So that's what
Absolutely.
that's one of the big routines. And a big and a huge routine that I really love is gratitude. And that's when I had a
I
huge
think
realization.
that's where our journey started with Lorelai and her
Yeah.
mastermind was we read
The magic.
the magic. I'm like the secret. That's not it.
It's the cousin. That's the
Yeah,
cousin.
that's the cousin. Yeah, and I saw you did some stuff also with Laura. I've been doing my gratitude actually with the paradigm shift with Bob Proctor every day. But it's the same thing. It's the same thing we've been doing. If every day you remind yourself or you just like you write down why you're grateful, like 10 things you're grateful for, it's life changing.
Well, let me tell you, this is where it's crazy, right? Whenever you are asked to do your gratitude, they tell you to focus on the good things that happened that day for you, right? That's the focus. Well, I think we all had that impression, and I think it's right, but it's also wrong.
Oh, I love this.
It is wrong, and I'll tell you why. We are in this self-development journey. Right, we are in this self-development journey, and we are taught to focus on the good, focus on the good, focus on the good. Right, they do teach us other methods to kind of release or whatever, but in particular with gratitude, they want you to focus on the good, and that's how I initially learned it. Right, and it's amazing, but honestly, I learned something the other day that just blew my mind. It was different from what I've learned in the past. And this is just my journey, right? People probably already know about this, but this was just my journey. So the first person to introduce me to gratitude, on a little bit more of a deeper level is Lorelai with the book. And it kind of got me into the waters, which was awesome. Thank you so much, Lorelai, for
Love you, Lorelai.
that. And then there's this other person named Mercedes. I think I'm messing up her name. She got me even deeper into gratitude because I was going through stress in my job. And then she said, I want you to do gratitude for 30 days about your job. I said, what? I'm trying to leave this damn job. You're trying to make me do gratitude about this job that I'm trying to leave? She said, yes. And you have to send me a picture of your first 7 days.
Accountability, what's up?
Accountability. Guess what? 30 days later, 90% of my stress went away.
Yeah, wow,
90%.
yep.
So that got me even deeper. So I started doing 30-day challenges.
So you were just focusing on what at your job was good, like you were writing down,
Yeah.
all right, my boss was cool today.
I
I incorporate that a
every
lot,
sen
like good day at work.
yeah, every sentence it starts with I am grateful for blah 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 blah. Right? So that's what happens. And then it just made me, do you know what that did? This is crazy. I work for a large bank. And what that did is it created a reorganization in the freaking bank where it took me and 500 other people from stress that was making me go insane and wanted to quit. It did that
I
whole
remember.
shift, and I'm like, holy crap. Anyway, that got me even deeper. And then just last week, I started a 30-day gratitude challenge, and I said, I want five people to come with me, and we ended up eight of us. And I haven't went out in a while, but then I said, I'm gonna go to a thrift shop. I went to a thrift shop and I saw this book. It's called Make Miracles in 40 Days. The reason I bought it is because I liked the cover.
It's
That's it.
awesome.
When I got home and started reading, this is crazy.
He buys a lot of books.
Yes. Let's not show them that. Anyway.
Sorry. So do I. So do I. I could say it.
When I got home and read a little bit of this book, it turned out to be about 40 days of gratitude. That's one.
Wow.
And that you have to share it with a partner. And I'm like, holy crap, I just that's what I was planning to do with those five people starting Monday. And somehow chance made me want to go and just get this, and it turns out to be about gratitudes. The different thing that this book taught me is this. You're not just going to write about what's positive. You are going to talk about what's negative.
Wow.
And
That's
that's
a
different.
that is different, and I like
That is
it. I
different.
want to hear everything about that.
That is different. And I'm like, what? That's
It's really
insane.
easy to talk about the stuff you're grateful for when shit's going right.
Yeah. Well, check this out,
And
right?
usually that's never always the case for everything.
Exactly.
Yeah.
The reality is you're dealing with shit and it hurts and it's stupid. You know what I'm saying? So what
Love
this
you.
book does, it gives you two ways. If there's something you're positive about, you're going to say, I am grateful for blah, 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 that I woke up early or I went to the gym, right? If there's something negative, you're going to say, I am grateful that. You're not saying this is amazing, but hey, this shit is happening. It is what it is, but I'm still grateful anyway.
So do you say I'm grateful that I tripped, or do you say I'm grateful
Yeah.
that I didn't, or do you say I'm grateful that I didn't really hurt myself?
Well, here's the thing. Don't sugarcoat it, right? It
Shit.
wants to release.
I'm a
It
sugar
wants
coater.
you to release. Here's the magic quote here. What was it? What pers what was it? What resists persist? Was it what resists persists or what resists? What's that quote? What you resist persists,
Yes.
right? And so,
Wow. Yeah.
what this is trying to make you do is, don't sugarcoat what you're feeling. Let it out. Don't push it down. That's it. Let it
Zal, are
out.
you serious? I have to write the shitty shit on my gratitude journal? Sorry,
Yes.
guys, with the cursing. I feel like I'm just here
It's
talking with my
real
buddy.
and it works. Can I tell you how it worked?
Yes.
Check this out. Every day, when my
That's
gratitude,
tough.
it is tough, but it's necessary.
Okay.
Check this out. In my gratitude, every day, and this is like the hidden subconscious stuff that messes around with us. I write, I am so grateful that I woke up on time for work. Now, previously, it's been 1 year. I dread waking up early. If I wake up at 8:30, I would, drink, get a drink, drink of water or go to the bathroom. I would go back to bed for the rest of the 30 minutes because I dreaded waking up. But check this
Okay.
out. Because I wrote, I am grateful for waking up at 9 o'clock. Yes, I'm grateful for that, but subconsciously, you know what is that reminded me of? Hey, you piece of crap. You know you want to wake up an hour early, but you're not. It's reminded me subconsciously that I really want to do something else, not just wake up. And that feeling I am repressing down.
Wow,
So I
so
shifted it.
interesting.
So I shifted it
You
to,
always push the bar.
right. So what I wrote is, I am grateful for waking up on time. But I'm grateful that I wake up on time for work, even though I wanted to wake up an hour early. I am acknowledging the negative aspect of this because I'm like, hey, it's great that I'm waking up on time, but I really feel shitty waking up the not waking up an hour early. Check this out. I
Damn,
swear to you,
damn.
this is my realization right here. I swear to you, Jenny, 2 days ago after I wrote that, automatically without my phone, I woke up an hour early and I didn't feel bad. I swear. And then I took a walk with my wife. And then today, the same thing happened, and I didn't feel bad. And I'm like, so you acknowledge the negative shit? You're going to change? That is crazy.
I love that.
And this is why my stress, I didn't understand it before, but this is why my stress went down by 90%. Because she made me acknowledge the things that are happening at work, even if they're shitty, but I'm still grateful anyway. And therefore, there is no resistance. I'm saying, hey, shitty things are happening. I'm still grateful, though. I'm dealing with it.
But how do you write that? Can you just give me one example? Because I'm a slow learner. So how would you write, like, my day sucked, but I'm grateful?
Yeah, I'm about to find one that's sucky right now. Oh, I am grateful that feeling pain in my kidneys means the broken kidney stone are moving out.
Okay.
It's painful, man.
Wow. How are you, by the way?
I'm doing.
How was your surgery?
It went well, surprisingly. They knocked me out. And
you look great considering you just had surgery.
It was a less invasive surgery. I'm really glad. But they knocked me out, and I had my crew shirt on. And the lady asked me, oh, what is that shirt? I said, you know Tony Robbins? She said, no. I said, well, we save lives. And that's all I remember.
I wear my crew shirt too much, but, like way too much.
So the whole point here is to write, you know, what hurts and not to try to predict the future. You know what I'm saying? To just say, this is how I feel. And I'll tell you why that works. When you're feeling really shitty, right? And then you go talk to a friend about, and when you're feeling shitty, you get all sorts of wild ideas of what you're going to do and how you're going to punch that guy. And man, he, you know what I'm saying? Then you go talk to your friend and you talk about it. And all of a sudden your mind changed. Like, what happened? You didn't take a pill to change your mind. Let it go.
Wow. Yeah.
Let it out. That's the whole point. Practicing this to let it out daily is where the magic happens. It's like, oh, since you're not resisting about what you're going through. Oh, here's some good stuff. Jenny, it's been one freaking year.
Thank you
year
so much, dude. I needed this today. I needed this. Just because you saw my journey deeply, but it's like, all right, I would deal with the suck and I would feel it and cry it out. But now I'm on this like, everything's good and blah, blah, blah. But that's like not good.
When we pretend that nothing bad is happening, when they're really
well, that's not true. That's not totally true. Like, I do voice some of the things, and I, especially with like working through boundaries and stuff, I've been trying to address my feelings more instead of sitting back and like taking it and being quiet about it. But I also didn't know that I wasn't supposed to just try to look at the good in every single situation. Like, it's important now, and especially maybe to write it out, like some stuff that isn't so positive.
It's
but still be grateful for it.
Authentic. It's really part of being authentic. Because you are putting down the things that you are really grateful for.
Yeah.
But you're saying, here, this is how I authentically feel. What does everybody teach us? Be yourself, be authentic, let it out. Everybody teaches that. Mm-hmm. When we write that in gratitudes, I'm only 4 days in and I'm realizing this. It's been one freaking year that I'm dreading waking up, and all of a sudden I'm okay with it. Like, how does that happen? Like, come on. You know what I'm saying?
I do.
There's a magic in this formula. I'm about to like slap this. You know what I'm saying? Oh my God.
Oh.
I'm like so excited because I haven't felt like this in 1 year, and it's just such a freaking gift. It really is. You know,
I do. Yeah. Is there anything else you want to share with us about different tools that you've learned that has helped you?
Absolutely. There's so many things that you can do, but obviously, if you're not consistent, that's a problem. That is a big problem. The only reason I was able to cut my stress by 90% at work is because I did it for 30 days, and I did the work, and I did it with intention. Right, when you're doing these gratitudes, you do it with intention, or to feel good, or to get better, to empower people, to help people, because that on its own goes a long way. And you know, with these, at least with these gratitudes, don't try to predict the future, you know? Just let it be, you know, because that's the best way. That is your medicine to kind of get that garbage out. It's honestly even making me connect with my religion even more. I've always read, I'm a Muslim by practice. And so there's a portion of that scripture that says, if something good happened to you, be grateful. If something bad happened to you, be grateful. I never understood it until today. I always like fought with that idea. But now, like, I realize you're doing this so you can release your emotions. Yeah, it's still happening, but you're releasing it. You're not giving it all the attention to destroy you. You know what I'm saying? So be consistent. When you're consistent, we know it works. Sometimes you might know the lesson, but when you feel the lesson, that's when shit starts to shift. Another book I'd like to recommend to kind of move you with that consistency is The Miracle Morning by Hal Elrod. Wow, that book is a life-changing book because it teaches you the art of creating a morning routine. Whether you have 1 hour, whether you have 6 minutes, whether you have half an hour, it basically takes all of your bullshit, all of your excuses, and says you can change, you can achieve your dreams, you know? And it gives you a routine that you follow, you know, where it incorporates writing, affirmations, visualizations, reading. It really has a nice recipe. So that's another really cool book that I really
I
recommend.
don't know what I would do without my morning routine.
Honestly, if people want to change, the reason I think we don't change is because we think about everything and it becomes overwhelming and we do nothing. And I think a big thing that I really discovered for myself is when I do 30-day things. When you focus on one thing for 30 days,
This actually started from a 30-day live challenge. This whole why we're sitting here right
boom. Yeah, you had videos one after the other. I'm like, who the hell have you been talking to? It was awesome.
Thanks. But
It's really good. I'm so
it's true.
inspired to see that, honestly, because the reason why you're loving it is because you're consistent. The reason why you're loving it is because you made it into a routine. The reason why you're loving it is because you put it as a mental vision and you met it halfway and you started calling people and you started talking to people.
They
You know,
started
people don't
coming to
just.
me.
Yeah. And then it kind of started rolling and boom. Like, you have no idea how serious I am taking this session. I told you I had to shave. I had to find my hat. I'm like, what shirt should I wear? I even meditated and then I did the Tony Robbins thing. I'm like, yo, I gotta get
You
ready for
prime
this.
too? What's
I'm
up?
primed. I primed for this. I primed for this. For real. Because, you know, we're here changing lives, man. I guess I really meant
Absolutely.
it to that nurse. We are here to change lives.
Absolutely.
You know, and it just really takes, you know, you talk to this person, you do this thing, you make a schedule for your day. You know, really honestly, if you take 10 minutes before you go to sleep just to write your top five things, like it's gonna take you 2 minutes. And you're gonna wake up refreshed, you're gonna wake up ready, you know. It's gonna take 2 minutes. Like, I'm sure you have that,
And it's
you
fun.
know? And it's fun because you're gonna start seeing things. It's just like being patient, obviously, and being consistent.
So, Zal, I know we have about 20 minutes. I know you have to pray, and I want to pray too. So, I want to ask you, what's your favorite food?
Oh my God. So I started eating healthy, right? I promised myself that I wouldn't get fat during this pandemic. And guess what? The universe, sure, let's make you suffer with a kidney stone so you don't eat a lot of crap.
That's another thing I want to talk about.
Yeah, so I lost like 10 pounds because of that, right? Because I stopped eating a lot of junk. I stopped eating a lot of junk. And that's everything happens for a reason. It absolutely happens for a reason. And when I was feeling like such cru you know, cruciating pain, you know, I would pray and I would say, you know, thank God I'm learning. And I just kept it at that. I'm like, this is painful, but thank God that I'm learning. And that kind of goes to the gratitude, right? I'm like, this is painful, but thank God that I'm learning because now I drink a lot of water. Now my body's healthier. Now even my choices of foods is so much better. And that kind of goes to your question. During this whole time, what I discovered is that I really like quinoa. Quinoa. So my wife makes it in a really, really nice way. So she takes quinoa with frozen vegetables or, whatever. And then she cuts like little pieces of chicken. And she puts all, look at them saliving. And she puts all
Invite
sorts
me
of like,
over. No, I'm just kidding.
she puts all sorts of Middle Eastern spices that just makes it so good and juicy.
Like
And she,
what?
I don't know what she does. She just put a
Okay.
whole bunch of
I
stuff.
had Berber from when I went to Dubai. I still have a little bit of that. That's
I
like
don't
a
know. She just puts a lot of stuff on it. And she uses obviously avocado oil, right? She doesn't use
Yum.
fried rice. And so like she does it. And dude, I abandoned rice. Rice was the
Yeah.
enemy. Rice and bread is the enemy and soda. It's the enemy. It is.
I've been loving
And so
cauliflower rice. It's so good. It tastes like rice.
she also did, she yeah, so she that's my favorite dish right now. She takes all sorts of vegetables and she makes it juicy and it tastes
I
amazing.
know
Like
this is like a weird question, but I like to know. Is the chicken shredded or is it cubed?
cubed.
Okay.
I haven't tried shredded. I mean, I'd love to try shredded.
I'm just
I'm open.
I'm always curious to like
Give it
if
to me.
like peop like when I make chicken salad, like do you like it shredded or do you like it cubed? Usually the
I,
traditional
you know
way
what?
is shredded.
Honestly, whether it's cubed or shredded, it has to be juicy for me.
Okay. You
It
don't want
can't
no
be
dried
dry.
out
Oh
chicken.
God. Oh hell no. No, don't do it. And it better not be cold. No, don't do it.
Yeah, I'm
Don't give
coward
me
for that.
cold chicken. Have you seen those salads with like chicken? I'm like, what is wrong with you? Why is it cold? You know what I mean? Like, I got used to like warm chicken like all my life.
You're so funny.
There's a bond that I have with chicken, and it needs to be warm and lovely. You know what I mean?
Can you
But
tell me
yeah.
one more thing? Like, all right, so Zal's from New York. You live in North Carolina now.
Yes.
And so can you tell me maybe like your favorite recipe that your mom makes when you come home or your favorite food when you come to New York? Like, what's your go-to? Do you come to New York and eat pizza? Do you come to New or
Oh no, I don't do pizza in New York.
okay.
No, we eat a lot of home food. There is a traditional food that they cook. It's from Yemen. It's called zom. They use flour and they heat up the I think it's yogurt. They put warm
How do you
yogurt on that flour. I don't know how they make it, but it tastes so good.
what's
If you
it
have
can you
any
spell it for me?
zom, I guess it's zom.
Z-O-M-E.
Yeah,
Okay.
zome. And it just tastes so good because it reminds me of my childhood and my mom makes it really good. But like our traditional foods has been like rice and chicken, man. That's what we're known for, rice and chicken. And so like I'm moving away from the rice and putting the alternative is quinoa. Now my mom eats quinoa, my sister eats quinoa. I'm like slowly shifting the I'm like bringing in the quinoa into the house
Starting a new
slowly.
tradition. I love it.
Yeah. And it tastes good and it's healthy. So it works out. I mean,
That's my goal. Like, I want to make good, healthy food that tastes good.
I'm going to ask her for the recipe, the step by step, and write it down, give it to you because I swear it tastes so freaking good. Oh my God. I'm hungry again.
So thank you so much for sharing that. I'm excited to make that, recreate that, and learn something new. And I also wanted to ask you if you had a superpower, which I mean, you're a ninja and you're obviously creating these powers now with
Jim
just
Borden Ninja, baby.
shifting your
Started at
mindset.
20 rockets. Yeah.
If you could have any other superpower, what would that be?
Man, the power of always being authentic. I think a lot of people struggle with that. And I know some people might choose like another crazy superpower, invisible or flying or whatever. I think I want that, right? Because whenever you taste the recipe of being authentic, it feels so good. Your walls drop. If that can be an automatic superpower, are you kidding me? It's like when you know yourself and you're authentic, you will never do the wrong thing. I mean, it's like you buy a phone, right? You get, you don't know the phone that much in the beginning, but you eventually know the settings, you know how to navigate it, and you're like an expert. You know it in and out. You know how to navigate it. And so being authentic and having that as a superpower, gosh, you'll always live happy, right? Because we're all after happiness. We're trying to make money to be happy. We're trying to get the stress out to be happy. We're trying to manifest stuff to be happy. At the end of the day, it goes to that. I feel like if you're authentic and you get in touch with yourself, that's like magic.
The greatest gift, yeah.
Honestly, that was the first word that came to my head. When you asked me before, I tried to think of a superpower and nothing came out. When you asked me again now, that was the first word that came.
I
And so it
love
was
it.
authentic. It was an
It
authentic answer.
was authentic. That word has been circulating throughout a lot of my conversations today. I was
Everybody
talking,
wants it. Yes,
yeah.
everybody wants.
Talking to somebody earlier, he's not even really in the self-development space. He's actually my guest tomorrow. But we were just talking about like when you don't really care what others think of you. Not that you don't care, but it doesn't affect you. Like the freedom of that, just like loving yourself, all the parts. You're gonna make mistakes,
Right.
you're gonna say stupid things sometimes. Like it's part of it. And I don't, was I talking to you or him about how it's just, I'm like losing my words because I'm trying to think. Like when you just show up to be like who you really are,
Yeah,
it's
just
like
show up.
people know when you're being real with them.
Absolutely, a
So
hundred percent.
why try not to be?
Exactly. And they love it. I honestly
Yeah,
think the reason
because
why
it gives
people
them
love
the
it,
freedom to do it.
right? I think the reason why people love it
IG.
so much is because they're missing in it. They're missing that part of themselves. And they're just like, man, you are so brave for showing up as you. And they admire you. And it just takes you to whole different levels because everybody wants that. Everybody has been trained to put a mask. For those that are brave enough to take it off, like we respect them so much because those are the people that change the world. Like when you are authentic and you're connected with yourself, you believe in that idea.
It was you, Nick.
Worries. No worries.
Sorry, I love
Oh,
you.
there he is. He's like, hey,
That
don't you let anybody else take credit.
No, we had a really good combo, and I'm really excited to share him with you guys as well.
That's amazing. Hi,
Yeah.
Aaron. Thank you for making time
Thanks for
today.
watching. So sweet. So Zal, I also wanted to ask you because I'm also like I haven't talked to you in a little bit, so I just wanted to see how you were doing during this whole unique point in history and how you've been, how you've worked through some challenges, maybe or.
No, absolutely. I think everything happens for a reason, right? We all believe in that, as crazy as it is. And I think we all know someone that got affected because of this pandemic. But I am so grateful for everything that's happening. Obviously, we are responsible for our own actions to protect ourselves and the people around us and all of that. And as crazy as this whole thing is, it is. But everything happens for a reason. I honestly think it's been developing people so much. And I've been like, the big realization that I've had so far is 30-day challenges freaking work.
They
That's my
sure
highlight.
do.
Yeah, this is my highlight of my pandemic, of this pandemic. 30-day challenges work because we're home. You have zero excuses now. Seriously. Like, the universe is looking at you right now. I'm like, come on, man. Like, dude, I gave you 5 hours every day. Like, you're not traveling, you're home. Like, here's 2 hours. Stop bullshitting me and tell me you ain't got time. You know what
Seriously. For real though. And I'm not saying this
Yeah.
because I'm saying I'm doing everything right. There's stuff that I want to do that I'm putting off sometimes. And it's like, I have no excuse. I mean, I'm a little busy, but I have no excuse, but that the fact that I'm being lazy.
And it's like, and I think so like 30-day challenges, and it's like, yeah, spend 30 minutes, spend an hour. If you're too busy and you really want to do this other thing, maybe it's time to cancel some of the things that are making you
Yeah.
busy so you can fit that 30 minutes.
I
Dude,
feel like
if you
you're talking to me. Like I'm not trying to make this about me, but it's like a lot of things that you've been saying, I just feel like you just helped me so much in this conversation.
This is not scripted, guys.
I just want to thank you for real, though. No, like, it's like, yeah. Sorry.
No, absolutely. I honestly think, like, for us, it's kind of like, it goes with what you said before. As long as you show up for yourself and you start to do one thing at a time for 30 days, what is it going to hurt? Like 30 minutes a day, 5 minutes a day, 10 minutes a day, that accumulates. And I don't have to try to prove it to you. You know it works.
The little things wind up.
Everybody has
make up the big things.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's so much like proof that when you're consistent with something like this, it works. And so when you put like that nice deadline for 30 days, it does some sort of magic. You know, like I did 30 days on gratitude and it changed me. I did 30 days on visualization and it got me to all sorts of rabbit holes. And I'm like, holy crap. It's like what Bruce Lee said. What did he say? Something like, I'm not afraid of a person that knows 10,000 punches. I'm afraid of a person that has practiced a punch 10,000 times.
Literally. I listened to, funny you say this, I listened to E.T. the Preacher.
Yes.
A lot. Like Eric he's on my playlist, like with my music and my hype music and stuff. And he says, like, basically, like, I don't care that you read a book and, you know, you read the book and you don't get anything out of it. He's like, how about you take one page out of that book and read it 100 times?
Yeah.
And it's funny you said that. Just reminded me of that, you know. So interesting. Cool.
It's like you've got to surround yourself with the things that are going to remind you of what you want to do. You know, like, I don't care if you are you overwhelmed, like right now, if you're watching, if you're overwhelmed with everything that's going on with, and you're like, oh my God, I have so much to do. Choose one thing right now, like choose one freaking thing and search it, read about it, obsess about it for 30 days. Like the world will still be here when you get back. Obsess with it for 30 days. And I promise you, I swear to you, you're going to be like, what the fuck? You know, what just happened? You know what I mean? It's
facts on facts.
So excited.
Thank you, so.
Absolutely.
So is there anything else on your heart you want to share?
Yes. Hi, I didn't plan, but honestly, you've got to get your story straight. You know what I mean? You really got to get your story straight. If you're feeling pain, like, don't live there. And I'm not saying to take yourself out of it completely, but use the tools around you to get out of there. I cannot, just because of what gratitude did for me today, I can't tell you enough. If you are going through so much bullshit, so much shit, get this book.
Yeah. Tony just asked what was the book. So he recommended
Make Miracles in 40 Days. If you got nothing else and you are confused and shit is going wrong every freaking day, all you need is this book in a notebook. Oh, this is mine. Let me show you my journal. This is my journal. Can you?
Things I shouldn't put in writing. That's funny.
Have fun, right? So all you need is a notebook and this freaking book. Read this damn book. And just
read the damn book.
Yeah. And just read and just do what it says for 40 days in your journal. That's it. That's
and what all. About what like, about Miracle Morning? What was that one? Is that just like a list of like things you could do to put you in a routine, a more detailed routine?
I would say the Miracle Morning is step two of this.
Oh, okay. Perfect.
That too, right. Because the Miracle Mornings shifts you into additional habits. It shifts you to meditating, to visualization, to writing, reading, right? It gives you more habits and it gives you a really nice structure. It's an easy read. It's really beautiful. But you know what? The theme here is not to overwhelm anybody. So all you need is this freaking book and a notebook. Read the damn book, do it for 40 days. Is that tough? Is that hard? No. But if you're feeling like shit or you're feeling amazing, do it anyway. 40 days. Like, it's going to go.
I have a question for you. So I would like to do this. And
Ooh, we're in day five, by the way.
well, I don't have the book yet. So as soon as I get the book, I'm gonna let you know when I start. And
we
in
can, you know,
40 days from that day, I want you to come back on the show.
but check this out. Check this out. We're already 5 days in. First of all, because we can connect offline, I can catch you up real quick. So you don't have to
Okay.
wait to get
All
the
right.
book.
What's up?
You can get the book, but I can catch you up real quick. We are on day five, right? Which is, it doesn't matter. You can start
My
whatever.
lucky
We're
number.
early in the game for you to start. And like I said, day four, and I'm already blown away. It's gonna come with your intention, and with your intention and really wanting
Gonna
to.
feel like I'm cheating if I jump in 5 days late.
No, it's fine, because it's your journey. I'm gonna do it with you till you
I'll do
finish.
5 days after. But I'm gonna jump in with you guys if that's cool.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Of course.
All
Yeah.
right, cool.
I forgot to tell you about the accountability, right? So check this out. Every single day, this is what I do with the eight people. Every single day, I do my 10 wins. I take a picture of it and I send it to the eight people, and they send me back their gratitudes as well, because this is the only way
That's
I'm
what I
gonna
did
blow
in
your mind.
Lorelei's. I was like, I'm not gonna do it if I just if it's just me
Yeah.
that
Accountability works. Get an
that's
accountability partner, do the same
I
project, and you'll change after 30 or 40 days. I promise you, no matter what subject you're trying to tackle.
that. All right. So you'll come back on the show after.
40 days.
Oh. All
Do
right.
it.
Well, I want to give you a few minutes before you jump on. Mary Lynn, what's up?
Mary Lynn! This is great.
I don't want to let you go, but it's
It is time.
time.
And I want to thank you so much. And like I said before coming on, I was so freaking excited. And, because obviously I respect you so much, I respect your audience, and I want to make sure we covered things that are super impactful and we are super present. And I think we really spoke. We didn't script none of this. We just put ideas out there, and we said we want to connect with people, with our hearts, obviously. And
Absolutely.
I hope we did that.
Well,
So,
I know you've beyond inspired me, and I have a really
and
good
they gave me
feeling
something
that
to do.
you've inspired the audience as well. Love you too, Mary Lynn.
You thought you were just gonna interview me and walk
I
away.
know. This is, I'm like, what? This is life-changing stuff right here. I'm serious. For real. I
Absolutely.
appreciate you.
I appreciate you for doing this, because honestly, if it wasn't for your consistency, we wouldn't be talking. And like I said, I'm just like so inspired, because I'm like, oh, you know how some people start something, they do it for, a couple of days, and that's the disease that a lot of us, go through. They do it for a month, and then, something comes crashing, and then they stop. But, not to put a pressure on you or anything, but
No, I love it.
you've been consistent. Boom, boom. And I'm like, who's this guy? Who's this person? Holy shit. Oh my God, another day. Whoa, the background. Like, it's been great. So it's so inspiring.
Oh, thank you all. All right, guys. Well, I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you tomorrow night. And I'll remind you again in 40 days when we'll be back on to talk about it. And I hope that you could join us in that journey.
Yes,
Love
absolutely.
you.
Let's go. Let's go.
Let's
Woo!
go.
Thank you so much.
Ciao,
Peace,
guys.
everybody.
Peace.
Peace.